This is our new Tesla Model 3 sedan. We've had it a couple of weeks, and in that time, I've driven it home, I've taken it shopping, I've even driven it up into the mountains for a little bit of fun. But what I haven't done is what I'm about to do now. I'm going to drive it on a test track and see what it can do. So I'm going to pretty much just step off the brake, step on the gas, and see what she's got. Oh yeah, that feels like a Tesla. That's properly quick. This has only got 258 horsepower, but it's rear drive and it puts it all down, and that's a pretty impressive launch for a car that in its cheapest form will cost $35,000. This one here is optioned up. It's got the long range battery and the premium upgrades package, so it's about 56. It's direct drive, there's no transmission, there's no shifting, there's no special mode I have to put it in. I just step on the gas, and even right now I'm in hold mode. I got my foot off the brake, so I just mash it and go. The Model 3 is laid out like the Model S. It's got a rear drive electric motor. This is not a dual motor Model 3. Those aren't going to be produced for a few more months. So the single motor in the back of this car makes 258 horsepower, which doesn't seem like a lot, but the numbers that it's generating, pretty darn impressive. It helps that it's rear-wheel drive. When I mash the throttle, all the weight transfers onto the drive wheels, and I get a great launch. Acceleration is strongest right off the line, which makes sense, and then it kind of flattens out a little bit at top speed. That's characteristic of an electric motor. They've got 100% of their torque at zero RPM right at launch. No surprise there. And since there's no gears for it to shift into, it's a direct drive situation, it just kind of plateaus. And the plateau depends on how much horsepower you've got, and we've got 258. I'm gonna try something a little different for this acceleration run. All Tesla vehicles have a gauge that shows how much consumption you're using instantaneously. Generally, if you wanna hit the rated range of the vehicle, you've got to get close to a certain number. In the Model S, that's about 310 watt hours per mile. That's higher in the Model X. We haven't figured out what it is in the Model 3. This is a more efficient car. It's a lighter car. To get its rated range, it's in the low 200s. But I want to know what kind of consumption you get when you just do one quarter mile run. So what I've done is I've reset the meter. Says 0 watt-hours per mile on trip odometer B, and I'm gonna punch it and let you know what it is at the other end. Here we go. It hasn't updated yet. 2,605 watt-hours per mile. It's down to 1,289 because I got on the brakes, but it was 2,605 the moment I lifted off. So. That's a lot. Next, I'm gonna try braking. We didn't buy the optional 19-inch summer tire upgrade. These are the base 18-inch all-season tires. So these tires may not have the grip necessary to get the best stopping distance, but I don't expect it to be terrible. Here we go. The thing about the panic stop test is it's good to know, you know, what the car is capable of in an emergency situation. But in most daily use situations, because this car is electric and because it has strong regenerative braking, you almost never need to touch the pedal. Straight line testing, acceleration, braking and the like, it's all well and good, but this is where it all matters. Putting it all together on a circuit. And this thing just jumps out of corners. Oh, a little out of shape there. I really like the way the steering is weighted. It's got three settings. This is the sport setting. Sport setting is a little bit better in terms of build up and feel. And the steering wheel is fantastic. Pillars are slender, the cowl's really low. Brakes are really easy to modulate. They're not as powerful as I'd like, though. I mean, rear drive, that's great. But the low center of gravity, because the battery's underneath the floor, that's awesome. And the weight balance is really feels good. It's just, I need a little more tire. That's it. That's what it comes down to. A lot of punch down this back straight. And the brakes don't feel like they quite have what I'd like right there. I really like the way it bends into the corners. Goes right on my line. There's a little bit more understeer than I'd like, but that gets back to the tires. Boy, but it really leaps out of that slow corner. Well, my average after those laps is 1,042 for a sustained lapping. That's a lot of fun. There's plenty of thrust from this 258 horsepower electric motor to really get your attention on the straightaway. And it comes out of corners really nice too. Tires are another story. I wish there was a little bit more grip, but that's partially our fault. These are the 18-inch base tires. These are the fuel economy tires. If performance matters, the extra $1,500 is probably worth it. But if you're into efficiency and getting the most range that you possibly can, the base tire is the ticket. Well, that's it for our first track test of the Tesla Model 3 sedan. But it won't be our last because we have this car for a whole year. During that time, we're gonna come back here, try a few things. Maybe our opinion will change, maybe it won't, but we're starting in a great place. For more information on this car and others in our long-term test fleet, go to Edmunds.com. And for more videos like this one, click subscribe.